Hello from Chem Help ASAP. Enolates arise from removal of a hydrogen from an alpha carbon by a base. Often a ketone will have two different alpha carbons with hydrogens. Which one gets removed by the base? This is a regiochemistry question. In the middle of the screen is a simple ketone. This ketone has two different alpha carbons. The left alpha carbon is a CH3. The right alpha carbon is a CH2. When treated with a base, which proton is removed? Well, it depends on the base. For LDA, a bulky, very strong base, you tend to remove the proton from the less hindered carbon to form the enolate on the left. So we have removed a proton from the CH3. For sodium hydroxide or alkoxides, you tend to observe removal of the more hindered proton to get the enolate on the right. The left enolate is called the kinetic enolate. The right enolate, which is more stable energetically, is called the thermodynamic enolate. Weaker bases, like alkoxides, favor the thermodynamic enolate. You might be thinking that, based on a previous video, we don't use hydroxide or alkoxides to make enolates. Well, in some cases we do, and in those cases we'll form the thermodynamic enolate. At the bottom of the slide, let's show a sample reaction. Let's take this ketone and deprotonate it with LDA and then treat it with ethyl bromide. What will be the product? Well, the starting ketone has two alpha carbons. LDA removes the less substituted alpha hydrogen. To give this enolate, in step two, we will add ethyl bromide. The enolate will attack. To give this product, the other alkylation product, the other regioisomer from the other enolate, where we put the ethyl group on the other carbon, will not be observed. The competition between the thermodynamic and kinetic enolates can be very messy and influenced by many factors. We will stick to the simple idea that LDA always gives the kinetic enolate and other bases give the thermodynamic enolate.